I've got the top 5 mistakes that new thermographers make in this week's IR Spectrum. We'll have those for you here in a moment, but first, the latest from ITC. Looking to get certified? You'll find our complete calendar online at infradtraining.com. We have a variety of dates available at convenient locations across the US and Canada. And for our fellow thermographers based in Europe, the Middle East, or Africa, irtraining.eu is where to go for the latest schedule there and information on how to register. As thermographers, we all make mistakes, especially when first starting out. I know I did. It's all part of the learning process and is why certification training is essential, especially if you're new. Classes from ITC teach you how to minimize these errors and help you get the most out of your investment in thermal imaging. As for how many mistakes one could make, well, there's too many to list here, but these 5 are among the more common errors that we see from new thermographers, especially those who are not properly trained and certified. Starting off at number 5, image quality concerns, especially focus. An out-of-focus image isn't just difficult to interpret, it also displays the wrong temperature. Focus needs to be perfect each time before saving an image. That's an important skill that we practice throughout certification training. Notice how the temperature changes here as we pull focus on this fused cutout lab in our classroom. When it comes to focus, there's no such thing as good enough. It's either in focus or it's not. Speaking of temperature measurements, setting the right emissivity or reflected temperature values in your camera is essential if accuracy is important. These and other object parameters must be adjusted correctly, otherwise your numbers will be off, significantly in some cases. Check out the measured values of this disconnect in an outdoor substation using 3 different emissivities. The resulting max apparent temperature value ranges from 118 Fahrenheit all the way up to 194. So which is it? Join us for certification training where you'll learn how to set these correctly to get the most accurate reading possible with your thermal imager. Thermal imagers detect the total infrared radiation coming from a target. That means what we see isn't limited to what's emitted by the object. Infrared cameras also pick up energy reflecting off the surface from other sources, causing surfaces to appear warmer or cooler than their true temperature. As an example, the side of this house really isn't cold, and this electrical bus bar connection really isn't hot. Certification training shows you how to identify these false thermal anomalies and avoid making the wrong call. A number of programs rely on temperature difference measurements as reference points when assessing severity. They do so, however, without realizing what they are seeing could likely be a lot hotter than what's displayed in their camera. Shiny metallic surfaces, such as electrical bus, have a very low emissivity. In this safe-to-touch training lab that we feature in our certification classes, what we see is only a small temperature difference between these 2 pieces of copper is in fact much larger. Certification training explains why and shows you what to do to get the best results. We have this at number 1 because it seems to be the biggest mistake made by those who are new to the technology, not buying enough camera, something that could cost you more in the long run. Now, it's certainly tempting to purchase just on price alone, but not all infrared cameras are the same. Resolution is a great example. In building envelope inspections, not having sufficient resolution means you might miss smaller insulation voids or areas of air leakage. These 2 thermal images of the same house were captured with 2 different infrared cameras. Both have the same field of view, but very different detector sizes. On the left is an 80 by 60 array. On the right, a 640 by 480. More pixels means more detail. If your application is outdoor electrical, higher resolution is essential. On the left is what we see with an 80 by 60 detector array with a wide angle lens. On the right, a 1024 by 768 system with a telephoto lens. We can clearly see the problem in one image, but certainly not the other. And that doesn't mean you shouldn't consider a low-cost camera. They do serve an important purpose in the marketplace. However, some applications simply demand better specs. So be sure to do your homework before you buy. Okay, that's our perspective on the top 5 mistakes that new thermographers make. What are your thoughts? Are there any that you've made which you'd like to share? We'd love to hear it. Leave a comment below so others can learn and perhaps avoid making the same errors too. One thing that's definitely not a mistake, getting social with ITC. We're on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and LinkedIn, where you can find the latest industry news, valuable tips, special training offers, and a whole lot more. And if you're looking for our complete training schedule, or perhaps just want to register for an upcoming certification course, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or check out our website at infraredtraining.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you online again soon.